Hey everyone, welcome to the TypeScript 5 for Absolute Beginners course. In this fifth lecture, we will see the introduction of objects, interfaces, and type aliases. And this lecture will cover understanding of objects and their properties, creation and usage of interfaces, optional and read-only properties, and then type aliases. First, let's discuss objects and their properties. Objects are a way to store multiple pieces of information together in a single structure. You can think of an object as a container that holds different boxes called properties. Each property has a name or key and a value. So let's create our first object in TypeScript 5. Let object name, which is person, equal curly braces. And now in these curly braces, we will write the properties of this object. First property is first name, second is last name, and third is age. Now if I want to print the first name of this property, then I can write it in the console.log. Okay, I'm going to print all the properties last name and age too. Let's execute it and print these all the properties in output window. And these three properties are printed. Next we have interfaces. An interface is like a blueprint or a template for creating objects. It defines the structure of an object, including the types of its properties. Basically, an interface is an abstract type that tells the compiler which property names a given object can have. So if multiple objects needs to be written, then one can utilize an interface as a template for writing multiple objects. For example, if I create more than one object of person, but if I accidentally skip the last name property in second object, then it will not give us any kind of error. If we want to create more than one object of similar type, then definitely we need to use interfaces. Let's create an interface of type person, interface person, and now we need to write these three properties, first name, last name, and age, in this interface. Now I need to extend these both the objects with the person interface, so that if I accidentally miss any property, then it will show us error. Now what is the basic difference between objects and interface? Interfaces define structure and types, and objects store actual data. This is the basic difference between both these interfaces and objects in TypeScript 5. Now if we talk about their existence, then interfaces are development only. They are not in compiled JavaScript, but objects exist at runtime. Then if we talk about error catching, then interfaces enforce specific structure to catch errors, while objects store data without error enforcement. Last is usage. If we see usage, then interfaces act as a blueprint or template, while objects perform tasks and hold data in code. Next topic we need to discuss in this lecture is optional and read-only properties. Now we will see practically how we can write the optional and read-only properties in interface. I want to specify my ID property read-only so that I can only declare it at the time of creation. As I added my read-only ID property in person interface, it enforces me that I must specify my ID property in these both the objects. Interfaces enforces the inclusion of all the properties in objects upon inheritance. However, if one wishes to specify an optional property, then we can do it like this. We need to use question mark with that property. Now it's up to me, I want to use this property in my objects or not. Next we have type aliases. Type aliases are a way to create a new name for a specific type in TypeScript. Let's create a type alias. To create an alias for a data type, use the type keyword followed by the name of the alias and then data type it represents. For example, age is equal to number. Now this age can be used to create an alias for the data type number, which can be used anywhere the data type number is required. Now I'm going to use this age alias in place of number. Let person age type equal 12. So this type alias was with primitive data type. Now I'm going to create with custom data type, for which I'm going to write again type person equal parenthesis, exactly like we define interface. Now in this person alias I'm going to write two properties, full name and age. Let's create a variable, let person1, and its type is this person alias. And now we need to define the properties full name and age. So this is the way we can use our type aliases. Next, let's see the difference between interfaces and type aliases. If we talk about extensibility, then interfaces can be extended and merged with other interfaces, while type aliases cannot be extended or merged. If we talk about usages, then interfaces are best suited for defining the structure of objects, while type aliases are more versatile, can be used with any type, including primitive types, union types, and intersection types. And this is it for today. Hope you understand the entire lecture. If you have any query or question, you can ask in comments. If this lecture was helpful for you, then guys, please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thanks for watching.